Everyone has their own working mom journey, and I'm gonna share with you my working mom journey. When and how I knew I really wanted to be a mother, when and how I knew that I wanted to work in addition to raising my kids, when the work-life balance was great, when it really got out of whack, and then when I worked hard to regain the right balance that was right for me and my family. So come on my journey as I explore this in the next 6 episodes of my working mom journey. I'm Mocha Mom. Welcome to Working Mom Warrior, where we help you dump your judgment, stop your stress, and relate to other moms who are sharing their successes and failures, including me. I'm really opening up in this segment. I'm giving you a 6-part, long-form explanation of everything that I went through from the very beginning when I realized, okay, I definitely want to be a mom, to the end as my kids are teenagers now, and I've gone through a lot of ups and downs, and I'm finding the balance that works for me. So I'm going to start with the very beginning when I knew I wanted to be a mom. When I was a little girl, I loved playing with dolls, and I always knew I wanted to be a mom. But I was really good in school, and schoolwork came easy for me, so I knew I was gonna go to college, and I knew I wanted to have a career. And of course, when I was little, I had, you know, all the same visions and dreams a lot of little girls have, you know. Oh, I wanna be an actress, I wanna be a singer, I wanna be a teacher, I wanna be all these things. I actually had a list of like 20 things, and I thought I was gonna do them all. Even then, I was going a little crazy with the expectations for myself. But every time I tried something, I was good at it, which is very encouraging. And I grew up in a wonderfully loving, encouraging home. My parents never pushed me to do things, but they always encouraged me. And when I wanted to try things and more things, I did. I got to the point where I did too much and I got burnt out. I feel like my daughter is going through that right now. I have a daughter who's 16 years old. I have a son who's 19 years old. And she always was good at everything she tried, excelled in academics, did a ton of extracurriculars. I knew she was doing too many, but I digress. I'm talking about my story. And so I got to the point where I went to college, didn't exactly know what I wanted to do, started taking some writing classes and some journalism, and then had an internship at a TV station in the TV news department. And I was just like, oh, this is what I want to do. It just like got under my skin. When you know you found your passion, it's so exciting. So I found it in college. And after I graduated, I couldn't get a job in my field right away. It was very tough, super competitive. I knew it would be. It was harder than I thought. I had never faced anything so difficult. So I got some jobs in journalism before I got a job in TV news. But when I got a job in TV news, I jumped at it. And I took a huge pay cut, and I moved across the country, and I was so happy and so excited. And then typical for a reporter in TV news, you move from small town to a little bit bigger small town to get your experience and try to move up to a big market. My goal was to always get to Chicago, which is where I grew up, in the Chicago suburbs. So I moved around from one small city to another, and lost a job that I really loved, because things in TV news change drastically whenever there's a new management change, and had to find freelance work when my significant other and I moved back to Los Angeles, where we had met, and eventually landed a really great job in Miami, where I thought my career was gonna take off, but it didn't, because again, the whole direction of the station changed, and I ended up coming back to the Chicago area because mostly at that point in my life, I knew I was ready to be a mom. I wasn't a mom yet, so I had told the person that I was living with that I had realized that this was my soulmate. He was my soulmate. We were in love. We both knew we were in love for a while, and we had been living together for a while. We weren't married. He's a musician, and musicians have like, a problem with commitment. I guess that was sort of my interpretation and the way I explained it to my friends. And I didn't care. I really didn't care if I was married or not, but I knew I had found the right person. And it was actually in Miami every weekend just about. We would spend curled up on the couch, like watching movies, and I thought, it would be so easy to have a couple little rugrats running around while we're doing this. I no longer feel like I'm missing anything if I'm not going out. I mean, I spent years in LA covering the entertainment industry and interviewing celebrities on red carpets and going to parties after movie premieres and living this kind of glamorous life. And I had a great time doing that, but I knew I didn't want to do that forever. I knew I wanted to go back to the Midwest and be a suburban mom. I know that's kind of crazy, and actually, and one of my boyfriends in LA thought that was completely crazy, and he didn't want to have anything to do with that life, and we didn't end up staying together. But this guy was different. He was more laid back, and he kind of went along with what I wanted, which is wonderful to find. He didn't just give into everything, but he didn't have a lot of ideas about his future because he wanted to be a rock star, and that didn't happen for him in Los Angeles. And when he moved away to kind of follow me as I pursued my career, he knew he was leaving that behind, not forever, but for a while. So I basically told him, I'm ready to have kids. I want to have them with you. You're going to be a great dad. You're my soulmate. I'm going off the pill, and that's that. A lot of moms kind of freak out when I tell them this story. They're like, didn't you have a big discussion and ask him what he felt? And I was like, no, I knew he'd be a great dad, and I knew I was ready, and I knew it was the right time. The only thing that really wasn't right is financially. I knew we were not in a good place financially. We weren't like on the verge of homelessness. You know, we both had jobs at the time, but we weren't like, you know, making the kind of money where you could like buy a house and all that. We were kind of starting to think of those things. But he just kind of said, okay. Like, he wasn't really ready for it. He wasn't totally on the same page as me, but he wasn't like ready to fight about it. He's a low conflict guy. And I said, listen, if this really isn't something that you want, then stop having sex with me because I'm going off the pill. That's the decision I made. So at least I informed him of it. I didn't try to trick him. I let him know what was going on. I let him know what I felt. And I think, to be honest, he wasn't sure what he felt. I think he just kind of felt like, I guess if it happens, she'll tell me and I'll deal with it. And then I went through some miscarriage issues, you know. We had some fertility issues, and so I lost a couple, and I was worried that he wouldn't even care, or maybe he'd even be happy, but no, he did care. He knew that it was tough on me. It wasn't as hard on me as I think it was on some other people because, well, the first one was early. The second one was tougher because I had to go in and doctors had to be involved. And but, you know, right when I was starting to get through this idea of, okay, maybe I have to go see a specialist, and they were doing some testing, and then I got pregnant again. I said, getting pregnant's not the issue, but then this one had the heartbeat that the others didn't. So my third try was a charm, and my son came along, and at that point, my significant other and I had both lost our jobs in Miami and moved back to the Chicago suburbs because I was yearning to go back to where I grew up, where I had lots of relatives and friends and felt like I would be surrounded by great support, and I was in a place physically where I wanted to be when I had my children and I was emotionally ready to have them. So he and my whole family were completely on board, and we never really discussed getting married. We were just focused on getting ready for this baby and being the best parents we could be, and I read 7 books about pregnancy. You know, this was in 1999, 2000, so this is really before like everyone just instantly turned to the internet for all their information. So I just turned to books, and I read books about all kinds of things, how to help your baby be smart. We did all these crazy things with like flashcards and stuff when our baby was little, and it wasn't crazy. I mean, it's different, but, and I read all kinds of books about being healthy, and I went to my, you know, pregnancy aerobics classes, and I, just like they say in What to Expect When You're Expecting, think about every calorie that goes in your mouth and don't make any of them empty calories. I had actually changed a lot of my habits. I wasn't the most healthy person in college. You know, I used to drink a lot of pop and eat a lot of sugar. And when I moved to California, I really became much more aware of the importance of health and its impact on the environment and your own psyche. And so I already was kind of a healthy person, but I became much more so. And of course, I didn't drink any alcohol or didn't do any, you know, any intake, anything, prescription or anything. And not that that's bad. bad if people occasionally, you know, indulge in this or that, you know, as long as you're discussing with your doctor and you're not being crazy. I'm not trying to make judgment on anyone else, but I was really hardcore about this. I mean, we were playing baby Mozart every night. We were reading books to the baby when he was in the womb. You know how it is with the first one. So he came along, he was a wonderful child. He like slept through the night by like the second or third month, you know. And at that point, I had gotten a freelance opportunity to work in TV news in Milwaukee, and I was commuting up there from Chicago, and they were actually wanting me to work 5 days a week, which I couldn't go back and forth because it's almost 2 hours each way. And so they were paying to put me up in a hotel. That's actually where my son was conceived, was in Milwaukee. Occasionally, you know, I'll call him husband because he's my husband now, even though he wasn't then. My husband was coming up and staying with me, and then he was working, you know, some freelance work in Chicago. I don't even remember when he got his big full-time job. You know, he eventually got a great job in his career that he loved that lasted for a while till the dot-com bubble burst. But I was really in a position where I had a job that wasn't a job. It was a freelance gig, which is common in the industry for media. So I was working 5 days a week. I was in the industry that I loved. I was doing the job that I loved as a television news reporter, going out and covering stories, being on the 10 o'clock news every night. But I was getting ready to have this baby, and I was getting bigger and bigger, and even though I wasn't driving every day, I would stay up there. I was going back and forth, you know, a few times a week, and driving a lot in the car and getting nervous, because I'm short, so I have to sit really close to the steering wheel to reach the pedal. So like my belly was practically touching the steering wheel, and I just got kind of freaked out. So about my 7th month, I said, I don't feel comfortable driving this much in the car anymore. It was, you know, I was getting like great stories. I was on the 10 o'clock news every night, you know. I mean, had I not decided to shift my career in a different place because of my children, I feel like I really would have kept going with that and gotten the awards and the bigger markets that many other people in my industry who I knew at the time went on to do. But, you know, once I stayed home for those last couple months to kind of get the nursery ready and do all that nesting and get ready for the baby and read more books, I realized, okay, I want to breastfeed, and I know that's very time consuming, and I don't know about pumping, and I don't know about this whole idea of like being gone, and especially that far away. The stress of handling a new baby is hard enough, but if you decide to go back to work, it can add to that stress. And I'm going to explain in the next episode of My Working Mom Journey how I came upon the situation of becoming a working mom when it wasn't what I originally planned. So as you get ready to watch this, don't forget to spread a little love to another mom who needs it.